আপনারা দেখছেন পিবিইউ নিউজ, কোচবিহার পঞ্চানন বর্মা বিশ্ববিদ্যালয়ের নিজস্ব ইউটিউব চ্যানেল।
হ্যালো এভরিওয়ান, দি স্টুডেন্ট অফ দি ডিপার্টমেন্ট অফ কমার্স কোচবিহার পঞ্চানন বর্মা ইউনিভার্সিটি উইল গিভ আ স্মল প্রেজেন্টেশন অন দি টপিক এনভায়রনমেন্টাল অ্যাকাউন্টিং অ্যান্ড ইনফ্লেশন অ্যাকাউন্টিং ফ্রম দি সাবজেক্ট কর্পোরেট রিপোর্টিং। This is a part of their internal assignment. I hope you all will enjoy this new mode of assignment. Now, the student will give their presentation accordingly.
Hi, I am Amiyo Barman, student of MCOM at Panchanan Barma University. I am going to discuss the topic of environmental accounting and its need and significance. First of all, I discuss the definition of environmental accounting. Environmental accounts provide data which highlight both the contribution of natural resources to economic well-being and the cost imposed by pollution or resource degradation. Environmental accounting sometimes referred to as green accounting, resource accounting or integrated economic and environmental accounting refers to modification of system of national accounts to incorporate the use or depletion of natural resources. Next, the need and significance of environmental accounts. First point of need, resource utilization. Natural resources, water, air, minerals, forests, etc. are required to carry on the business activities of every firm. Also, the functioning of an enterprise has some favorable and some adverse effects on the environment. Hence, there is a need for maintaining accounts of the effects of the activities of business entity on the environment and natural resources. Second, resource availability. Environmental accounting is useful for disclosing how much natural resources are available in the country, their incomes and cost incurred to use them and their depreciation values, etc. Third, social responsibility. Environmental accounting is helpful for measuring industrial development and social welfare and fulfillment of social responsibilities by companies. Companies are urged to be accountable to both shareholders and wider society. Profit making is not considered as the sole corporate objective. Number four, qualitative study. Traditional accounting system is restricted to quantitative and monetary aspects only. Hence, environmental accounting is necessary to analyze and affect the environmental resources in the entire business function of a firm. Fifth, environmental protection. Environmental accounting will help in evaluating the problem of environment protection. The business activities of enterprise should be recognized as society environment-centered and not only profit-centered. Number six, going concern. Environmental pollution and substantial cost associated with cleanup activities, fines, compensation and bad publicity, etc., can even significantly affect the share prices and even the stability of a company. Hence, environmental accounting awareness is required. Last point, social accounting. Social accounting has been the precursor of environmental accounting. Social cost also include the use of natural resources and pollution of environments, also preservation of the Environment is critical factor for sustainable development. So, environmental accounting deserves special attention of manager, investors, society, different branches of government and other stakeholders. We understand the environmental and its need and significance. Environmental accounting would be the best weapon of the modern business management to create accountability in the society as well as to save the environment from the present condition. It can be used like a mirror of the business organization to show what impact its activities can create on society. Thank you.
Hello friend, my name is Rajiv Sharma and I am a student of MCOM in Kochibihar Panchan Barma University. Today we will discuss about environmental accounting. Let's start. The definition of environmental accounting. There are no standard definition of environmental accounting. The term environmental accounting was first brought into the common usage by economist and professor Peter Wood in 1980. India's former environment minister Mr. Jairam Ramesh first time raised about the need and importance to bring the environmental accounting practices of accounting in India. Environmental accounting is an attempt to broaden the scope of accounting frameworks used to assess the economic performance, to take stock of elements that are not recorded in the public and private accounting books. These gaps occur because various costs of using nature are not captured, being considered in many cases as externalities that can be forwarded to others or postponed. It refers to a broad range of issues related to the interaction of economy and society with the environment. It aims at achieving sustainable development, maintaining a favorable relationship with the community, and pursuing the effective and efficient environmental conservation activities. These accounting procedures allow a company to identify the cost of environmental conservation activities during the normal course of a business, identify benefit obtained from such activities, provide the best possible means of quantitative measurement in monetary value or physical units, and support the communication of its result. Environmental accounting can be defined as a branch of accounting that deals with activities, method and system, recording, analysis and reporting, and environmentally induce the financial and ecological impacts of the economic system. Environmental accounting, also known as green accounting, resource accounting, integrated economic accounting and national accounting, etc., refers to the modification of the system of national accounts to incorporate the use or depletion of natural resources. Forms of environmental accounting. Environmental accounting can be classified into four forms. These are environmental management accounting, environmental financial accounting, environmental cost accounting, and environmental national accounting. Environmental management accounting focuses on material and energy from information as well as environmental cost information. It can be classified into three subclasses as segment environmental accounting, equivalence environmental accounting, and corporate environmental accounting. Second, environmental financial accounting. Environmental financial accounting refers to the financial accounting practices with special reference to the reporting of environmental liability cost and other significant environmental cost. Third, Environmental cost accounting. Environmental cost accounting defined as the use of accounting records to directly assess the cost of products and processes. It directly places a cost on every environmental aspect and determines all types of cost or related action. Environmental cost comprise into both internal cost and external cost and relate to the cost occurred in relation to the environmental damage and protection. Last, environmental national account. Environmental national account focuses on natural resources. Resources, stocks, and flows. Environmental cost and externality cost, etc. Functions and roles of environmental accounting. Functions of environmental accounting divided into internal function and external function. Internal functions are carried out within the company. In a company's environmental information system, internal function makes it possible to manage the cost of environmental conservation and analyze the cost of environmental conservation activities versus benefit obtained and promotes the effective and efficient environmental conservation cost and benefits from associated activities, which contributes to the decision making of stakeholders. Internal functions assess the cost incurred by the environmental conservation activities and related benefits and are beneficial in improving the efficiency and effectiveness of environmental conservation activities and help in gaining an understanding of what impact such activities might have on business operation. By using environmental accounting as an environmental information system, it plays the role of a tool to be employed by the management and related business segment. External function. By disclosing the quantitatively measured results of its environmental conservation activities, external functions allow a company to influence the decision making of the stakeholders, such as consumers, investors, and local residents. External functions are effective in conveying information about the company's environmental activities to the stakeholders. Environmental accounting data is made public through environmental reports and covers a company's stance on environmental conservation activities and concrete measures being taken by the company. By disclosing such information, the society's trust and confidence in the company improves and aids in achieving a better public assessment. Therefore, the environmental accounting not only fulfills a company's accountability to the people outside of the company, but also facilitates attaining a fairer corporate assessment, not just from the viewpoint or standpoint of environmental conservation.
Hello everyone, myself Kiran Agredi from Kuch Bihar, student of Panchanan Verma University from the Department of Commerce. Today, I am going to understand about the function and role of environmental accounting. So let's get started. The function of environmental accounting can be compared with the function of any kind of accounting. For instance, financial accounting helps to know the figure of profit earned for a business for a particular period of time. In the same manner, environmental accounting have to know the benefit or cost for any environmental activities. The function of environmental accounting are divided into two parts. First one is internal and the second is external. Let us first understand internal function. So, internal function are those roles which environmental accounting plays for the organization itself. Environmental accounting act as an information system for the organization. It provides management to the information to the management about the environmental accounting that are being undertaken and benefit or cost attached to it. Internal function make it possible to manage environmental conservation cost and analyze the cost of environmental conservation activities versus the benefit obtained and promotes effective and efficient environmental conservation activities through suitable decision making. Now the second one is external function. We will now understand the various external function. As environmental accounting acting as an information system for the internal management, it also act as an information system to the management. The outcomes given by the environmental accounting are communicated to the various stakeholders. This function in environmental accounting is even more important than financial accounting, as the steps that are being taken by the business should reach to all stakeholders, including the environmental activities and even to the other fund in the business, as these activities would like as act as a stepping stone for others, and the reporting company would gain in terms of compliance and emerge as a positive brand. By disclosing the quantitatively measured result of its environmental conservation activities, external function allow a company to influence the decision making of stakeholders such as consumer, investors and local residents. Internal function are carried out within a company. They assess the cost incurred by the environmental conservation activities and the related benefits, and are beneficial in improving the efficiency and effectiveness of environmental conservation activities and help in gaining an understanding of what impact such activities might have and understand of operation. External functions are effective in covering information about the company's environmental activities to stakeholders. Environmental accounting data is made public through environmental reports and cover a company's stance on environmental conservation activities and concrete measures being taken by the company. By disclosing such information, society's trust and confidence in the company improves and aids in the achieving in the better public assessment. Therefore, environmental accounting not only fulfills a company's accountability to people outsiders in the company, such as consumer, investors and locals. Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening. Myself, Purpita Shah, student of MCOM from Kuchbehar Panchanan Varma University. Today, I will discuss about the topic of national level of environmental accounting and its drawbacks. First, national level of environmental accounting. Firstly, national level of environmental accounting denotes a set of aggregate national data linking the environment to the economy, which will have a long-term impact on the economic and environmental policy making. Number two, this requires necessary amendments to the system of national accounts to incorporate the use or depletion of national resources. SNE is a set of accounts which every national government complies requires to which every national government complies routinely to track the activities of the economy. Number three, SNA data are used to calculate the major economic indicators including GDP, GNP, savings rate and balance of trade figures. The accounts are prepared by all countries in a standardized form using a framework which is developed by the United Nations Statistical Division. It helps international comparison and thus allows to place individual countries in the context of world trade. And now my second point, drawbacks of national and level of environmental accounting. In its present format, the SNA does not include full economic value of the environmental resources. SNA has to be amended in view of the following problems with the present system of national accounts. Number one, non-recognition of environmental expenditure. Expenditure to promote the environment from the damage or to mitigate the environment degradation cannot be identified the segregate from the SNA data. Number two, non-market goods and services. The environment provides certain goods which are not sold but are they are high level, but their value are high level. So for example, fuel, wood and building materials generated in the forest and medical plants, etc. However, some countries do not include this in their annual income accounts, estimating total consumption and then using market price of comparable products as an alternative methods to calculate the value of non-marketed goods and services. Number three, consumption of natural capital. The SNA treats gradually depletion of physical capital as depreciation rather than income. However, the depletion of natural capital, forests and in particular as accounted as income. Most experts of environment accounting agree that depletion of natural capital should be accounted for in the same manner as in case of other physical assets. That's it. Thank you.
Hello everyone. Welcome you all by myself, Shehnaz Khatun. I'm a student of Kuch Bihar Panchanan Barma University, Department of Commerce. I'm going to discuss on a topic, why inflation accounting and why not historical accounting methods of inflation accounting. It means the question is about that, why we will consider inflation accounting methods, but in another hand, we will not consider the historical accounting methods. So now let's make discuss on it. First of all, let's clear your ideas about what is inflation accounting method and what is historical accounting methods. First one is inflation accounting. Inflation accounting is a method where accounts are prepared with the changes of price level. This method is also known as accounting for price level changes. Under this method, balance sheet or financial statement are prepared with the changes of prices of assets. Next one is, what is historical accounting? Historical accounting is a method where accounts are prepared without changing the prices of assets. Under this method, balance sheet or financial statement are prepared without making any change of values of assets. Now, I am going to explain why we will consider the inflation accounting methods, but in another hand, we will not consider historical accounting methods. The reason is that, as we know that, in inflation accounting, we take the current price of the assets and liabilities while preparing the balance sheet, so it's give a true and fair value of financial statement. But in another hand, under historical accounting methods, balance sheet does not show the true and fair value of assets while preparing the balance sheet. I'm giving you an example to understand you in a bit easy way. Suppose you have bought a car before 3 years for ₹5 lakh. Now you just think, after 3 years, is the price of that car is still same? Obviously no. Why? The reason is behind that, because the price of the car is increased due to inflation. Suppose Now, after 3 years, the value of car becomes rupees 10 lakh. Now, in inflation accounting methods, if we charge depreciation, then we will take rupees 10 lakh, which is current price of the car. But under the historical accounting method, we will take rupees 5 lakh or historical cost as a value of car for charging depreciation. So we may say that the historical cost methods does not show the true or fair value of financial statement, whereas inflation accounting method show the true and fair value of financial statement. Another reason is, in inflation accounting methods, profit and loss will reflect the true condition of the company, but in historical accounting methods, profit and loss will not reflect the true condition of the company, because here the depreciation is charged on historical cost. Next, historical accounting methods is failure to disclose the current worth of the enterprise. The accounts presented on the basis of historical concept do not show many effects due to the inflation gap. There is also so many reasons, but I have just discussed the main reasons. Hope you have understood this topic. Thank you so much.
Myself, Manwar Hussain, and I am from CBPU Commerce Department. Today I am going to analyze CPP, current purchasing power method. So let's start CPM. What is CPM? CPM is also known as the general price level accounting. Actually, CPM is nothing but it's a general price level of accounting method, and this method is recommended by Accounting Policy Board and also the FASB of USA Board. And some of the steps of CPPM. Number one is calculation of conversion factor. This step refers that the restatement of historical figure. In this step, we need to restate of historical figure of current purchasing power, and for this purpose historical figure must be multiplied by the conversion factor. Number two, distinction between monetary and non-monetary accounts. This step refers that the CPP method, all asset and liabilities classified into two categories. Number one is monetary items and second is non-monetary items. Step number three, gain or loss on monetary items. Monetary items are receivable or payable in fixed amount irrespective of changes in purchasing power of money. Number four, valuation of cost of sales and inventories. Cost of sales and inventories values vary according to the cost of flow assumption, that is first in first out and last in first out, that means FIFO and LIFO. Number five, ascertainment of profit. Under this method, profit can be determined into two ways. Number one is restatement of income method and second is net income method. Restatement method is, under this method, historical income statement is restated in the CPP terms, and net income method is it's based on the normal accounting principle that profit is changes in the equity during an accounting period. Number six, restated balance sheet. This historical balance sheet is prepared as per the historical income statement, so it cannot represent the revised or changes value of assets and liabilities. This is the steps of CPP method.
Hello everyone, myself Asha Das from the Department of Commerce, student of Kuch Bihar Pancharan Barma University. So today I am going to discuss about the topic of current cost accounting method and some of its features. So before that, let's discuss what current cost accounting method is. The current cost accounting method refers to an approach that values assets at their fair market value rather than historical cost. And the method attempts to measure the effect of individual rates of price changes on all the assets and liabilities, that is stock, plant and machinery, inventories, investments, loans, creditors, and so on. It recognizes that there may be great differences in the rates of inflation of various items, and by using specific indices for items or groups of items, the method attempts to match the current cost of assets used against current income generated by them in more meaningful manner. The chief objective of this method is to ensure that the operating capital is maintained at the current price level. Assets are valued at current cost, considering specific price index of the relevant assets and not general price index, as it is used in the current purchasing power method. Profits under this approach are computed on the basis of what the cost would have been on the date of sale rather than actual cost. Current cost accounting method has ramifications that permeate the entire S&A. It affects all the accounts and balance sheets and their balancing items. A fundamental principle underlying the measurement of gross value added and hence GDP is that output and intermediate consumption must be valued at the prices current at the time the production takes place. This implies that goods withdrawn from inventories must be valued at the prices prevailing at the times the goods are withdrawn, and not at the prices at which they entered inventory. So we have discussed about current cost accounting method. So let's come to the point, what are the features of current cost accounting method? So the first point is, the fixed assets are recorded at replacement cost value in the balance sheet. The second point is, inventories are shown at the market value rather than market or cost price, whichever less, as in the historical system. The third point is, revaluation surplus are transferred to current cost accounting reserve but not distributed as dividend to shareholders. Number fourth point is, depreciation of fixed assets is to be calculated at replacement value. Number fifth is, there are two types of profit that is calculated under current cost accounting method, that is profit from operation and profit from revaluation. Number sixth is, liabilities are recorded in their original value because there is no any change in monetary unit. So these are the features of current cost accounting method, and towards this I end my topic. Thank you.